I'm Joseph Dominic. And if you ever thought about making a difference in a kid's life, come on in and let me show you how.
If you have a desire to work with at-risk kids or a passion for helping make a difference in the lives of others, this is the job for you.
John Watts, obviously, is a candidate for judge here in the 7th Ward. Speaking of which, all over Hammond and Ponchatoula are big events this weekend, including the chili cook-off for the Rotary Club in Hammond, where we are now. Like a mini festival, and I'm not sure how many it is. It's a great event.
We have, this is the Sunrise Rotary, which I'm a member of the Sunrise Rotary here in Hammond, in which we would like to invite everybody out to even come to a meeting that we may have. But we raise a lot of money for the parish. So everything here is for charity, and we have 31 teams that are entered. We got great sponsors. We have live music. We have vending that's going on. It's a great event if you have time to come down here in Hammond.
Well, are you going to be a judge, to coin a phrase?
I hope so, on the 26th of March. However, we have judges that we have, like I call it, double blind judging for the chili.
Well, that's good. And there were other chili cook-offs, like for the Oyster Festival, that sometimes the judging was criticized. But in any case, your campaign has a phone bank going on today?
We have a group that's canvassing. We have a phone bank that's going on. And, of course, I have a great deal of people here at the chili cook-off that are sponsoring. And I'm not cooking the chili, thank God.
Well, it's hard on a day like today because look at all the events in Ponchatoula, and I know you want to have a presence there too, but it's a good problem to have.
We run thin of volunteers when you start stretching out so many events in one day. We were at the Mardi Gras parade last night. We rolled with that, getting in about 11 o'clock and then getting back out here at 6 o'clock this morning.
Well, what are you hearing on the campaign trail? I wonder how many people even know there is a judge's race.
It's thin. There's not many people that actually know there's an election. Hopefully with the advertisements that we're doing, the door-to-door, the mail-outs that's going to be hitting, and the phone calls, and to remind them to go vote. And guys, look, early voting is March 12th, and we have March 26th is the election. So we expect a very small amount of voters to come out, so your vote's very important. So if you can tell your friends, your neighbors, anybody to go vote on that day and remind them, you know, March 26th.
So there are four candidates now. We know there will be four, and they all say that they're the best for the job, the best qualified. What do you say makes you the best candidate?
Ken, well, let me tell you something. I'm an ordinary guy, Ken. I'm your next door neighbor. I have been practicing law for 32 years. I'm the most experienced candidate that's running here. I've been in the courtrooms, it seems like, all my life.
You came amazingly close. You've run for judge once before. And this 7th Ward judgeship, as a matter of fact, and I think you overperformed most people's expectations.
Ken, that was a very big race in the primary. We ran against a 24-year incumbent. I'm a registered Republican. I ran against a Democrat there in the primary. I came short. I think we had a little over 27,000 voters that voted, and I came up short by 246 votes. That was that hidden, the mail-in ballot came in and overcame us. Election day, I won election day, but just didn't make it in the mail-in ballot.
Well, this will be a completely different election because the turnout is going to be much lower. Everyone agrees with that. So like you say, whoever goes to vote, their vote's going to count a lot more.
Every vote counts. Everybody's going to have their base in this race that come out. But we're trying to get, it is going to be literally door-to-door, phone call to phone call. Every volunteer that we have, please go down to your contacts and call your friends and get them to the poll. 25 votes could make the difference. This is a very small, it's a special election. It's not recognized. Not many people, believe it or not, have any business with the court, and so may not even go out and vote, especially a day like today. It was pretty cold. The sun's coming out now, but if you have a little rain or anything like that, that's going to really knock the bottom out of the election.
What else do you want to tell us?
Look, I am running for 7th Ward judge here, and this is everywhere from Hammond, Ponchatoula, Pumpkin Center, Baptist. This is a very important race. It's a time for change. If you're into change, I'm the guy to do the change. I'm going to establish an eviction court. I'll have court weekly. I'm doubling the court dates. I'm telling you, I'm doubling the court dates. We don't have court. The current court is only a 6-day-a-month court system. I'm going to double those dates, put in that eviction date to help our landlords out, and I'm also going to add a code enforcement court to help the people in our neighborhoods that are living next to this blighted property. We're all having those issues, and I'm going to take some responsibility because I have properties myself that are experiencing some of the same problems. Let me tell you, one of the things is I'm for the working guy. I started out working construction with my dad, and I'm going to help out by adding that night court. I'm expanding the docket, and I want to be able to help everybody out to have that option. If you have business with the court, I'm going to give you the opportunity to do it at night after work where you don't lose a day's wages. I'm number eight, Ken. I'm number eight here, and I'm asking everybody for their vote.
So on that subject now, you're triggering something I want to ask you about, which is, say you are a working guy, you don't have a lot of money, maybe you have a couple of traffic tickets, and if you could get a payment plan, if you could get some kind of a deal that you wouldn't have to come up with a couple of $1,000 at once, and look, it adds up. What about being a little creative to get those people that are just essentially hiding out because they've got several traffic tickets?
Well, Ken, we have the pretrial diversion program, which is I would like to expand that. However, that's for a little bit more than traffic. Currently, you can go in and do, most anybody can do the online payment system with traffic tickets. Most jurisdictions, I'm the magistrate judge for Springfield. I'm the only judge running here, and we do take payments up to 6 months to help those people out. I don't want anybody to have to, you know, to get into a bind. And we have an evening court there, and most everybody there are either a student, working. They each have hardships.
You don't have a night court now, correct?
Yeah, we have an evening court.
In Springfield.
We have no night court here in the city of Hammond or the 7th Ward. I will have that immediately.
I'm Joseph Dominick, and if you ever thought about making a difference in a kid's life, come on in and let me show you how.
Our children are the future of our communities. However, some of these young people have found themselves entering the juvenile justice system, where they now need help and direction. Here, the dedicated staff at the Florida Parish's Juvenile Detention Center provide that. They are the role models that positively impact young people by providing educational opportunities and social skills training to help eliminate criminal thinking and reduce the likelihood of a youth re-entering the system. The goal is to provide each child with a set of skills to become successful members of society.
Florida Parish Juvenile Detention Center is a great environment. They really take care of us, and it's really great pay.
One thing I like about working here is that it's really rewarding and I get to work hands-on with the kids.
If you're looking for a career in juvenile justice and have a desire to positively impact the lives of young people, the Florida Parish's Juvenile Detention Center offers an unparalleled employment opportunity for you. We have positions as juvenile detention officers, supervisory and management personnel, counselors and social workers, nurses, food service staff, and many more. The generous employment package includes employer-provided paid training, paid vacation and sick leave, shift work positions allowing several days off, holiday pay, opportunity for annual merit pay increases, 100% employer-paid health, dental, and vision insurance, Louisiana State Employee Retirement System, LASERS, participation, tuition reimbursement program, employee counseling assistance program, and standard issue uniforms and meals provided. When you become a part of the team at the Florida Parish's Juvenile Detention Center, you will be working with a dedicated and committed group of staff whose mission is to improve the lives of at-risk youth while keeping our communities and the public safe.
You can forever change a life. You can be that positive adult role model that makes a meaningful difference.
The Florida Parish's Juvenile Detention Center has been recognized nationally for improving the outcomes of troubled youth. Our programs are designed to challenge young people to see themselves and their future differently while giving them hope. It is a challenging job, but the rewards are tangible. If you have a desire to work with at-risk kids or a passion for helping make a difference in the lives of others, this is the job for you.